My name is Jiang Li. I'm the composer and producer for this album, The Art of Chinese Xiao and Hulusi. The Heart of the Dragon Ensemble is the UK-based Chinese band. Basically, most members are UK-based Chinese musicians. We have been working together for various different projects throughout the years. And then, although we sometimes come together to do the project, which is under the umbrella of Heart of the Dragon Ensemble, but individual members of the musician they also have their own project. For example, Joanna Chiu, she has her own opera, Chinese Opera Society, to run. And then Ruijun, which is another key member, which is the xiao player for this album, he's also a very famous artist on his own right as well. So the member of the Heart of the Dragon Ensemble is various different musicians come together. Even we have sometimes projects to work with musicians in China. This album come about when we are talking about our work, our life. And we realized that previously we do a lot of traditional Chinese music, but in the modern life, we do integrate into the English society. That's the initial idea, how to make an album, which is to cross the two different cultures, have the traditional Chinese elements, but also mix the modern Western instruments together. So this is the first experiment of Heart of the Dragon Ensemble. Within this album, we got mainly is two main instruments. One is hulusi, played by Joanna Chiu. The other one is xiao, played by Ruijun. Now, I have been working with these two musicians for many, many years. I know them inside out, so I know what they can play, what they're good at. And then because for this quite intimate kind of relationship with them, and then I exactly know what the music and the expression, the way they interpret the music. So that gives me a very good advantage to make a tailor-made music for them.
My name is Joanna Zenghui Joanna. My Chinese name is QIU Zenghui. I'm the director of the UK Chinese Opera Association. Before I live in Beijing, now I live in UK, London. I play the hulusi in this album. This part made of a gourd, in Chinese called hulu. This bottom part made of a bamboo. It's a main pipe from middle, that's one. I got a three finger from left-hand side, another three finger from right-hand side, and one hole at the back, some covered. But by the side, they have a secret one. They have a little hole here. If I close, there's a single note. If open, there's a company note. So this instrument sounds very special. This hulusi, which is in South China, Yunnan province, Dai people. Originally, they have a lot of material, easy to get it. That's like everywhere they can make the instruments easily. Also, the people use this instrument when they daily life, they give a work, or even the particular festival time, people play this one. Normally, a boy play the instrument, and the girl dancing company with this. Instrument about more than 1,000 years old history. It's a very long history instrument. I discovered the hulusi about 30 years ago. I can play lots of different Chinese instruments. For example, erhu, guzheng, xun, these are the Chinese Beijing opera instruments, jinghu, yuechin, and a lot of percussion. But the hulusi, it sounds different than anyone. When I was in university, one day I passed the classroom. Some teachers from other university come to us, they teach the instruments. That's my first time I heard this instrument. And they make me stop working. And this sounds amazing. straight away I loved the instruments. And this instrument for me is special because of any time I play this one, I just got a feeling like in the dream, because taking me to the Yunnan, particularly the area, the place. So that place is what we call tropical area. Lots of big tree and plants, lots of water, and even the house made of a bamboo, banana leaf. It's very special. And this sound, which is just taking you to the place, coming closer to the nature, different than the any other instruments, which is, I really like it.
So hulusi is one of these ideas because we are very rare to hear this instrument in the West. So we heard a lot of Chinese violin, Chinese harp, guzheng, but this instrument is the new thing of a sound, new kind of a style. I'm very interested to have this opportunity to introduce this new sounds and new instrument to the Western audience. The hulusi track you hear called The Affection of the Dai Nation. This particular track is actually a traditional piece of music, especially for the Dai Nation. And so this track you can hear is the expression of the culture of the people. So for the hulusi, it's very difficult, actually simple to play, but difficult to write instrument because the hulusi, the key range, is very limited, only got 8 notes. So whatever you write, you have to be written within these 8 notes. So this particular music is fit for this instrument very, very well. Okay, this piece of music you hear, the live version, is also a little bit different from the album as well, because this one is purely a piano go with the hulusi. If you listen to the album, they have a few more instruments. So this is a very interesting kind of a sound we experience today, which is work with Joanna. She understands which part my position's in, and also I give her space to express her melody as well. So it's a new experiment. I'm very happy with the result for this part.
With this piece, particularly can take it scenery to that place. More like a Chinese painting. If you see Chinese painting, like you can see through and take you to the place. For through this music, you can take you to the Dai people life. It can take you to imagine the girl walking down by the river, the play with water, and the people laughing with happy. And that's a place which is very relaxed, very beautiful.
My name is Ruijun Hu. I'm a member of Heart of Dragon Ensemble. In this album, I played xiao. Chinese flute is two types. One play horizontal, one play with vertical. The vertical one called xiao is which I played for this album. Flute was developed over 2,000 years. In the beginning, only 3 or 4 holes. During the last, 2,000 years, the development from 3 to 4, 5, 6. Recent, about 20 or 30 years, they added the show for 8 holes. So in this 8 hole show can play, if plays good, can play chromatic scale. I really interested in Chinese flute beginning, which is D, play horizontal, the flute, the bamboo flute. That was when I, about 6, 7 years, the time is Chinese the time is a period called Cultural Revolution time. I was a little. The first song I play, you know, called Dongfang Hong. Just, I don't know, the Do Re Mi or this, just when I listen to, just trying the horse, just play the sound. Gradually play little by little. And I didn't go to music school, but gradually I was taught by several different masters. For sure, I was, when I first played these, afterwards I found the sound more nice and deep and elegant. So I started to play xiao, but together, sometimes more flute. But recently, most time I play xiao.
The xiao can very good to express the music I am writing for, particularly for this album. In particular, its vastness. And because the xiao have the kind of language, the kind of sound and the kind of expression I need to express this piece of music, which is inspired by the poet Li Jiang. In fact, I write this music is based on his poet called Vastness, Chinese called Kong Ling. So the xiao I choose is especially for this particular sound, which is got a lot of space, a lot of empty space, a lot of contrast between the modern life and also the busy life, and a lot of people need it, which is their own space, their own search, own soul searching. So sometimes you really need your own space in a busy society. So this song, this track is the kind of a contrast to express that kind of a feelings. When the audience listens, you might find space, you might find stop, you might find some blank space. So that's what we need in a very busy society. So you can really relax, can put you into sleep. So, but that is the kind of things we sometimes missed in a busy life. So this xiao sound and also the melodies go very well together. Yeah, especially with a modern interpretation, which is the piano sound and other Western instrument string and together. So, and then that's expressed that kind of feeling very well. You're going to hear a live version of the Vastness. We're going to play live with Ruijun. This version is very different from the album, but we pick up the key thing. We pick up the main thing from this particular track, which is we put the piano and the flute together. They complement each other. So they fill up the space very, very nicely. So sometimes you will hear the together to express a feeling, an emotion. But sometimes you can feel they're actually separate. They do their own, the separate things. But occasionally, they interact with each other, just like a conversation between the modern and the ancient. So it's between the left and the right, or between the yin and yang. So it's a kind of experiment we're trying to do. So for this particular version, you will hear very different in different ways. For example, you might say, the melody, some part is missing, or the melody, some part is a repeat, but that is on purpose. We let it flow, let it feel like a live version, let it feel when we get to that particular point, we feel that needs a time to stop, we stop. We need a time to stretch, need a time to build up. So that's the live version. It's a variation which is have a more like a live interactions rather than pre-designed version.
Vastness, these pieces in this album, is one of my favorite. Composer Jiang Li gave me this music. When I just try to play, suddenly I feel I love it, because this music, the feeling very, the space and the deep. So in the nowadays, you know, busy, noisy people, you know, very cannot keep quiet. when we recording that before, I was practice, just try to play as good as I can, as Jiang Li, as our composer wanted.